Have you ever seen a number like 1/2 and another number like 0.5 and wondered, wait, are these two numbers different? Nope. They're just two different ways to show the same amount. Today, we're going to learn how to turn a fraction into a decimal. Imagine we want to convert 3/4 into a decimal. So we use our traditional division symbol, you know, we place the 4 outside and the 3 inside. Now we ask, how many times does 4 go into 3? Well, 4 doesn't go into 3 because 4 is bigger than 3. Then we write our first 0 because it can't go in. What do we do now? Looks like we need a little extra help. Aha! That's why the decimal point comes in. We place a decimal point after the 3 and don't forget to put a 0 right after it. But wait, why are we allowed to do that? Great question! Adding a decimal and a 0 does not change the value of the number. 3 is the same as 3.0, or even 3.00 or 3.0000, they all mean the same thing. We just add the point 0 so we can keep dividing. Now we continue. And guess what? We also place a decimal point above the division line in the quotient. Now that extra 0 we added lets us keep dividing until there's no remainder. Pretend there's no decimal point for a moment. Now we treat 3.0 as 30. Let's ask, how many times does 4 go into 30? The answer is 7 times. Because 4 times 7 equals 28, that fits just right. If we tried 4 times 8, it would be 32, and that's too big. So we write 7 in the quotient. That's the answer on top, right after the decimal point. Now we subtract. 30 minus 28 equals 2. We still have a remainder of 2, so we're not done yet. If we have a remainder, we just add a 0 to the dividend and bring it down to continue dividing. Because 4 can't fit into 2, we bring in another 0 from our decimal extension. Now ask, how many times does 4 go into 20? That's easy, 5 times. Because 4 times 5 equals 20, we place 5 in the quotient. Now subtract. 20 minus 20 equals 0. No remainder. That means we're finished. So, the final answer to 3/4 as a decimal is 0.75. Look at this one. Let's convert 2/5 into a decimal. So, we start by using our traditional division symbol, you know, the one that looks like this. We place the 5 outside and the 2 inside. Great! Now we ask, how many times does 5 go into 2? Well, 5 doesn't go into 2 because 5 is bigger than 2. What do we do now? Looks like we need a little extra help. That's where the decimal point comes in. We place a decimal point after the 2 and don't forget to add a 0 right after it. But wait, why can we do that? Adding a decimal and a 0 doesn't change the value of the number. 2 is the same as 2.0. Or even 2.00, they all mean the same thing. We're just writing it in a new way so we can keep dividing. Now we also place a decimal point up here in the answer, called the quotient. This new 0 allows us to continue dividing. Now let's think. If we ignore the decimal for a second, 2.0 becomes 20. Let's ask again. How many times does 5 go into 20? That's easy, 4 times. Because 5 times 4 equals 20, perfect. So we write 4 in the quotient right after the decimal point. Now subtract, 20 minus 20 equals 0. No remainder, we're done. So the final answer is 2/5 as a decimal is 0.4. Imagine we want to convert 1/8 into a decimal. We start with our traditional division symbol, put the 8 outside and the 1 inside. Great! Now ask, how many times does 8 go into 1? Well, 8 doesn't go into 1 because 8 is bigger than 1. Now we write our first 0 since the number doesn't fit yet. So what do we do now? We bring in our secret weapon, the decimal point. We place a decimal point right after the 1 inside the division bar, making it 1 point something. Then we add a 0 right after the decimal point, Now it looks like 1.0. And just so you know, 1.0, 1.00, they all mean the same number. We add zeros to help us keep dividing. Also, place a decimal point in the quotient, the answer area, right above the decimal point in the dividend. So now, instead of asking how many times 8 goes into 1, we ask, how many times does 8 go into 10? The answer is 1 time. We write 1 in the quotient, right after the decimal point. Next, multiply 8 times 1 equals 8. Now subtract 10 minus 8 equals 2. We still have a remainder of 2 not done yet. To continue, we bring down another 0. This 0 comes from the dividend. We bring down this 0 next to the 2, making the new number 20. Now ask again, how many times does 8 go into 20? The answer is 2 times. Write 2 in the quotient. Multiply 8 times 2 equals 16. Subtract 20 minus 16 equals 4. Still a remainder of 4, keep going. Bring down another 0. Again, we bring down the next 0 from the dividend after the decimal point and place it next to the 4, making 40. Ask, how many times does 8 go into 40? That's 5 times. Write 5 in the quotient. Multiply 8 times 5 equals 40. Subtract 40 minus 40 equals 0. No remainder, we're done. So 1/8 as a decimal is 0.125. Convert 5/8 into a decimal. We start with our trusty division symbol. Place the 8 outside and the 5 inside. Now ask, how many times does 8 go into 5? Well, 8 is bigger than 5, so it doesn't go in yet. Now we write our first 0, since the number doesn't fit yet. No worries. This is where the decimal point comes to the rescue. We place a decimal point right after the 5 inside the division bar and add a 0 after it. Now it's 5.0. Ask, how many times does 8 go into 50? That's 6 times. Because 8 times 6 equals 48, write 6 in the quotient right after the decimal point. Now subtract 50 minus 48 equals 2. Still got a remainder. Keep going. Bring down another 0. We bring down this 0 next to the 2, making the new number 20. Ask again. How many times does 8 go into 20? That's 2 times. Because 8 times 2 equals 16. Write 2 in the quotient. Subtract 20 minus 16 equals 4. Still not done. Bring down another 0. Bring down the next 0 from the dividend, placing it next to the 4, making 40. Ask, how many times does 8 go into 40? That's 5 times, because 8 times 5 equals 40. Write 5 in the quotient. Subtract 40 minus 40 equals 0. Woohoo! No remainder, we're done! So, 5/8 as a decimal is 0.625. And that's how we turn fractions into decimals one step at a time. Thanks for watching. Keep practicing and you'll get even better at math. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you won't miss any fun lessons. See you next time!